Kia ora, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to welcome you here to Aotearoa New Zealand, especially for our visitors, and it's their first visit here to our beautiful homelands of Aotearoa. My name is Zella, and I'm just going to explain what you are going to be part of this morning. It is a Māori pōhiri or a welcome. We welcome you here to the shores with what we know as the welcome chants. You will hear the sound of the conch, which alerts you that as visitors, our home people, Ngāti Whātua here, are ready to welcome you onto our lands. You will also hear the cry of welcome, or the karanga. The karanga welcomes you onto our village. So if you can just imagine yourselves coming onto a village in Aotearoa, in the village place are our home people waiting for you. The sound of the conch, the karanga, haere mai te manuhiri e, welcome to you, our special visitors. We then offer the chants of welcome. We add embellishment to the words by offering you a mihi. A mihi is a speech of welcome, which we do in our own native language. And in our speech, we recognise those who have passed before us, and that's also including your families who have passed before you. We acknowledge our Māori or life forces, our mountains, our rivers, our harbours that gave us sustenance during times of life. And then we welcome you and your families in spirit, wherever they may be. We embellish the words of the speaker with a waiata or a song. And then following that, the person who's going to do your welcome speech or thank you speech on behalf of you all today is Jordan, and Jordan will accompany me on the stage very shortly. We then conclude the welcome with the hongi, a very unusual ceremony. It's the pressing of noses, the sharing of breath between the home people and you, our visitors, and Jordan will do this on your behalf. So with that, ladies and gentlemen, that's a very brief outline of the pōhiri process that you are part of. Even though you're sitting there in your chair, you are still part of this special welcome. So nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, ki ora.
Te matanga, te baba butuga, te rapata te omeka. Koutou rā, o ngā matu, koutou matu rā ki te pō, oi mai rā, takutu atu rā. E mi rā, kia koe te rangati rā, nau mā e piki mai, haramai. Haramai rā, inga whakara pāru me koutou, koutou ngā reo, o ngā waka, nau mā e, haramai e piki mai. Tēnei te mi kia koe te rangati rā, nau nei, kamai atu rā, tēnei kaupapa. Ka wea tūrā ki roto i te motu. Koutou mai nei ngā mai, e mi tēne ki a koutou katoa. Hone te rangatina, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā ki tātou katoa.
E aha te hau, e aha te hau.
Tēnā koutou katoa. He mihi mahana ki a koutou ngā rangatira o Ngāti Whātua. Tēnei te mihi ki ngā tangata whenua o tēnei rohi. Ki a koutou mā, kua tautoko hia te karanga o te wā ngā mihi nunui. Ka huri au ki tōku reo tuatahi. My warmest greetings to you all, to those who belong to this region, to you who have heeded the call of this event, and to the tangata whenua of the Rohe for welcoming us so well this morning. Welcome everyone to NetHui 2015.
Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the formal part of the welcome. So I guess our internet group, whānau, deserve a warm round of applause, don't they, for that waiata? And so do our whānau here. Thank you, Julian. Thank you. Well, now that you've seen the formal part, we thought it is nice just to introduce, especially our visitors who have travelled, what we call a combined action song, poi, just to welcome you here to this space and to this land, and we will conclude with our ever-famous haka. And the haka is the most powerful and yet aggressive of our dances. You ask, why is it aggressive? Because it was a dance performed prior to going into battle. You will see the protruding tongue, the women bulging their eyes, the men slapping their chest. These were used as acts of intimidation to frighten and scare the enemy. And the haka was so powerful that if the enemy was so scared, they would retreat, which meant the haka itself had already won the battle. So this is our combined action song, Poi Dance, followed by Te Haka. You can clap. Thank you. Well, it is one of those dances where you don't know how to react, but thank you. I know, it is frightening. Imagine if you had, you know, a battalion of haka. My gosh, I think the enemy would retreat. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy your stay. A very warm welcome to Aotearoa once again. And on behalf of Raukura, nō reira tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Kia ora.
Hai.
Thank you. And now I'd like to welcome on stage is Michelle Arcourt, who is your mistress, master of ceremonies. Kia ora, Michelle.
Thank you so much to Zella, and good morning to everybody. Tēnā koutou katoa, no mai, haere mai ki tēnei, rā, whakahira hira. I'm Michelle Acourt, and it is a pleasure to be back with you again for a third year with NetHui. I don't feel so much like an MC, I feel more like a participant these days. And of course, this is not a conference in the normal sense. This is a gathering of people who have set your own agenda. These 2 days are all about you. And a bonus for me already this morning is that I'm getting to see a lot of the people that I spend time with in the virtual world in the flesh, which is always fantastic. So it's really nice to finally meet some of the names behind the Twitter handles. In the room, we have people who work in telecommunications and tech businesses, self-employed people, freelancers, employers, workers, public servants from a range of ministries, from the education sector, from the media and the non-profit sector. What I like about spending time with you guys is the level of engagement and intelligence and open-mindedness that you bring to these discussions. The sense that you really want to be here because the internet is an important part of the way that you engage with the world and where you get your knowledge from, and open access to ideas matters to you. It's especially exciting this year. If you look around the room, you will notice that people involved in NetHui this year range in age from about 75 years old to 12 years old. I'm nearer one end than the other, but it's really nice that we have such a broad range of people represented in the room. So over the next 2 days, we've got expert voices, we've got non-expert voices, which are often even more intelligent. We've got some politicians, some community-led discussion sessions, workshops, keynotes, plenary panels, a whole range of ways of sharing ideas. At the heart of NetHui is always those one-hour discussion sessions on topics and issues that have been suggested by the NetHui community. This really is led by you. So, and we also have some evening events, and there will be opportunities to drink and buy t-shirts. So, you know, it's a full program. So a very warm welcome to every single one of you. Let's aim to make the next 2 days a really shining example of collaboration and information sharing, asking, answering, storytelling, and creative planning. I've got some housekeeping to run through before I introduce Jordan Carter to you. I'm sure I don't need to remind all of you to switch your mobile devices to silent. Let me introduce you to the NetHui NetTui. This is how we're going to keep the program running to time over the next 2 days. We have a very special time warning, which has been gifted to us by Radio New Zealand. It's going to be used in this room and also in the breakout rooms during discussions so that you know when it's time to start wrapping things up and then when it's time to get going. So I'm going to get Sean to play, first of all, this is the 5 minutes to go, NetTui, which is quite gentle and friendly and charming and delightful. Quite relaxed. Oh, thanks, Sean. And it can go longer. And then at full time, we've got a really seriously quite angry Tui, which gets even angrier in a moment. Yeah, there you go. So once you hear that, I do a really good impression of a Tui. I need you to move. It's time for whoever's talking to shut up and move on. So thank you to Radio New Zealand for releasing the bird to us. I understand that it wasn't harmed in any way in the recording of that sound. So the program is on your name tag. You'll get the brief program on the inside your name tag. For full program details, go to 2015.nethui.nz NetHui.org/program. It's a fully interactive program on the website. You can click on any of those links which take you to collaborative note-taking. Please do get involved with that when you're in sessions. Just click on to the note-taking facility so that you can, so we've got a record of what happens as well as you expressing what you think is going on in those sessions. So do contribute to that. On people's name tags, you will notice that many of them have dots. You can get some dots for yourself if you would like them. An orange dot means that you're staff, you can't have one of those. A yellow dot means that you are a fellow. A green dot means that you are facilitating one or more of the sessions during the next 2 days. A blue dot means that you are a person who is new to NetHui. So do at morning tea, lunchtime, afternoon tea, keep an eye out for people with blue dots and make them feel very welcome. And a red dot means that you are a NetHui voice. I'm going to explain that in just 1 second. Live streaming is happening for all of the sessions throughout the next 2 days, apart from at Bar Camp and in the Chill Out Room, which are over there. So that means that if you are asking questions during discussion groups or in these plenary sessions, you need to have one of these in your hand, because otherwise the people who are watching this being live streamed won't be able to hear your questions. So please do make sure that you have a microphone before you ask your question. There's also captioning this year, as you can see up on the screen, that we're trying this out this year as a way of facilitating communication to people who either are hearing impaired or have difficulty with language or any of those kinds of things. Sometimes it's much easier to read what's on the screen than it is to listen. So I already mentioned t-shirts. I'll talk about those again later, but they are beautiful and good. Catering is happening. Morning tea, afternoon tea, lunch is all provided in the promenade area out there. Facebook is the lunch sponsor, so a huge thank you to Facebook for that. Parking, I know, had to be done. Parking, $15 for all-day parking. That's one in, one out. You can't go in and out all day, but it's $15. Take your NetHui badge downstairs to level 4 to get your parking validated at the services desk. Bathrooms, half a level up, half a level down, straight out there. In the unlikely event of an emergency, the exits are clearly marked. Staff will show you downstairs to the evacuation area, which is out on the street. In the case of any kind of emergency, please do dial 111. Jordan Carter is going to talk to us about the kaupapa very shortly. What I want to say is that everybody is welcome here. And one of the observations that was made last year is that sometimes during Q&As, it's less likely that women are going to answer questions, ask questions, sorry, not answer them. They're really good at answering them. I do a lot of conferences, and here's what I have observed. When it's a largely women's gathering, women ask lots of questions. When it's about 50-50, as it kind of is here, women often don't ask questions quite so often. And there are all kinds of reasons for that that I don't really need to go into. I'll probably write a column about it next week. But what we would like to do, we talked about this last year at NetHui, that what we would like to do to encourage women's voices is to designate some, or ask people to volunteer themselves as NetHui voices, so that if you are somebody who for any reason finds it difficult to stand up in a room of 400 people and ask a question, you can get somebody else to ask that question on your behalf. So to do that, you can either look out for somebody who has a red dot on their name tag. What I would like to ask any women who feel good about being a NetHui voice now is to send out a tweet and just hashtag it, hashtag NetHui voice, obviously all one word, so that we know who is willing to ask questions on behalf of other people. And then what happens is that when it comes to Q&A time, if you want to have a question asked on your behalf, you can either send it to that particular person, or just ask the question, put hashtag NetHui voice into your question. If you are a voice, you will be keeping an eye on that hashtag stream, and you will be able to pick up those questions, put your hand up, we will bring you a microphone, ask the question on your behalf. Are we all happy to go along with that for today and tomorrow? Is that a good idea? I really like it, and I think it will work. So let's do that. And one last thing I'm going to mention to you before I hand over to Jordan is that at the end of today and the end of tomorrow, we've got 15 minutes set aside for a wrap-up. And what I want that to be is for people who have been in discussion groups or to come back and tell us something amazing, something they've really liked, something they didn't like, an aha moment, any of those things. I want you to think of that wrap-up session at the end of the day as being like the comments board on a stuff website, but with really nice people. It's really hard to imagine. I do understand that. So that's your opportunity to feed back to the group so that everybody feels like maybe they've heard a little bit about everything that has gone on during the day. Great. So that's us started off. That's us kicked off. And to get us really properly settled into what we're doing for the next 2 days, let's do some scene setting with Jordan Carter. Jordan is the Chief Executive of Internet New Zealand, and he's been with Internet New Zealand since 2013. His background is in internet policy and strategy, and he takes a really special interest in the economic opportunities created by the internet, as well as its capacity to improve people's lives in social and cultural ways. He's an all-round good dude. Would you please welcome to the stage, Jordan Carter.